Millennials and Generation Z Filipinos at the forefront of taking advantage of big investment opportunities in 2020, at least according to registered financial planner David Angway. Thanks to digitalization and relaxed requirements to open bank and investment accounts, Angway says the new year presents several investment options for everyone, especially the young retail investors.
Number one, money market fund. Money market is actually a really good way or tool that can earn higher than your time deposit. There's this one company who's actually offering 100 pesos as an entry level way of you just to get into the investments.
Aside from the money market, newbie investors can look at placing their money in bond funds, which earn at least 4% yearly, while stock index funds or investing directly in the stock market can earn more than double that. However, Angway clarifies there are some years returns turn negative for stocks. That's why he explains unit investment trust funds or UITFs can be a safer but still good option for retail investors with a minimum investment of as low as 2,000 pesos or around $40. But Angway warns while options are many, all that glitters is not gold.
You should always trust but verify.
Right.
You don't trust all the way and then bet everything.
Right.
So make sure that you understand first who you are as a person, how much are you willing to lose. If you cannot explain how the money will work and it smells like fishy, then might as well not invest to that.
Based on a survey by the Philippine Central Bank, 37.5% of Filipino households set aside a portion of their income for savings, with 66.9% of them keeping their hard-earned cash in banks. Despite this, retail investors are still few and far between, with less than 1% of the population investing in the stock market.